had him in the meeting, but like you said, I think the company deserves it.
So what have you got there, Ray? I got four.
What'd you do? He missed one, Timothy Tracy.
Yeah.
Steve Hawk Avenue, Carol.
So what other one did I miss? Jason Smith.
Who's that? Probably that one, no pile.
I think because I didn't see anything in the county.
Yeah, I had one in no pile for a couple of years.
He's the one that moved around.
Yeah, he moved a lot.
From hospital, from the hospital to across to Greeley to Harlem.
I had him in no pile.
Where it might be a year or two or something, but it moved again.
Stepping stone.
Yeah. Yeah, not stepping stone.
So I got four. I got a Shelley Kent, Patricia Smith, a Thomas Meyer, and a Chris Rodman.
So you get three of my four.
Which one did I get on?
I have one in my yes pile, but I don't know which one was now.
Three of my four.
Oh, Weston.
Four, I can have Michelle call him and set up an interview. And do you want to do the interviews during council meeting? Do you want to do that separate on a separate night? Call them all in on different times?
But then we were looking also at us for more for mental.
Yeah, and some of them, I don't know, they were taking those on as others.
We went out to say, Kirk, we cut time down considerably, sure.
I don't think we should be able to have it each interview done in 45 minutes, what do you think?
Yes, I think we do is maybe try to set some sort of wage.
Question, oh yeah, wage, yeah.
Because that's probably going to be one of the questions that they're probably going to ask.
Yeah, I guess we shouldn't walk through that.
Well, we don't really know too much about any of these people, and then Chris.
What does the city feel, where does the council feel comfortable at for starting wage?
Well, I guess we need to determine what their duties are going to be. And we've been all over the board with different people doing different things. We hired a city clerk to do the clerking responsibilities, and city employees that are working out in the field have nothing to do with them. We hired somebody to put in the report to, what do we have?
Rob's got a valid question.
Personally, I would like to hire somebody that's going to give us the number, because the city council's ultimately responsible for everything, so I guess, you know, we can kind of know what's happening out in the community, if we know what the numbers are. For another city administrator, I guess.
Well, I'll state this. If Rick would report, or not report, but communicate with the clerk, and those two would put their heads together, because he's going to be your outside man. He knows what needs repaired, what needs fixed, and what should be attention. He knows how to prioritize what needs to be done. And then maybe the clerk could say, okay, we've got X amount of dollars that we can put forward towards this priority project right down the line. Does that sound feasible?
The city clerk is going to get telephone calls for what matters have to be looked at too. You know, somebody's going to call them in, you know, for they got a problem someplace. So the city clerk's going to get that and have to relay it to the outside.
To Rick, whether it's a electrical project or it's a water project or what kind of, whatever it is.
Yeah. But, I mean, they're going, the city clerk's the one that's going to get the first phone call. That's just how I think, you know.
Maybe before we start doing our interview processing, maybe we should do that, Rob. But just what you said, maybe we should come up with a list of job duties for that person.
Well, we have that one from the clerk administrator. Do you have a copy of that? If we get that, we can take things out that we don't want in there. You can leave things in that we do want in there.
Some sort of a base salary that you'd like to start this person at?
Well, that depends on their duties. You know, I mean, yeah. We have a person that, let's say our electrical project that went south. I'd be looking for a communication person for that. Who would that be?
And different people would be more capable of different things.
Yeah,
that's what we hire.
Yeah, I guess it would depend on your job qualifications also.
And are we going to put that on Clark's shoulders, or are we going to put that on
the outside field people?
Yeah. If so, then I believe we need to have someone in charge on the field.
I think these are the first duties to be done.
Basically.
Yeah.
You know, administrator is just titled. Clerk, every other town, the clerk does it. Anyway. They just don't put the administrator title on it. You go to Auburn and all that. They see the clerk totally.
Yeah.
You know, the city employees look good.
Audible.
Yeah.
Joel Yagerson, the city clerk in Melville.
Yeah.
And she tells.
Well, I don't think much to do.
Okay.
Not that one.
I think Bill runs the show over there, don't he?
Pretty much.
I guess my feeling, if it had anything to do with numbers and finance and, you know, utility billings, collection, that should be city clerk. You know, if I've been doing outside work, I suppose, you know, we've got in the...
And somebody we can work with.
I would say the city clerk's relaying more to the outside people what needs to be, what the complaints are, what needs to be done. Mm-hmm. She's the one's going to get, she or he, whichever one, is going to, the ones get the call.
And I think, you know, to me, that's a minor part of the job.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very important part of the job because that's where you're meeting the public, but it's not going to be most of the job.
No.
That is, you know, and we have...
there's a hell of a lot. The county, the federal office.
And, you know, you get into things like grant writing, you get into things like development, how far are we going to go? Thus far, in our two city manager people that we've had, our city administrator clerk, they've all been strong in different areas and weak in other areas. And those are the areas that surface and get people fired up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because everybody thinks this person is a super person that knows how to do all this stuff. Three, supervises all city departments, including evaluation, promotion, approving use of leave, and the administration of all disciplinary action in the matter.
I think they're going to have to do it. I don't know how you get around it. Not being a big part struggle outside.
If you're looking at somebody that's going to do financial and accounting functions, you don't have to look for somebody that's also going to evaluate or promote management. Probably our job is small town. I just don't think the city clerk needs to do that.
See, I think number two is a better thing. Consults with and advises other city employees to assist the private utilities and work hires, rather than supervises all city departments.
Yeah.
I think we should just take number three to do it out.
I suppose somebody needs to approve the leave. And there's something, that's a county function.
Yeah.
Probably an important county function. So I don't know that you have to evaluate and determine promotion, but you might be the only one that might know how much the leave they have. Maybe some clerk.
It's true.
And the person that they have a leave. So I don't know how you restate that.
Why can't you just can't you move just approving the use of leave to push it up to number two?
Okay.
Consults with advises other city employees to assist in prioritizing work items, resolving problems, communicating needs and activities of the city, and approving the use of leave.
tax program, kind of money back as well.
That would come.
Yes. That's an accounting function, yeah.
Coordinates the preparation of the city's budget, monitors the spending throughout the year, put it in the account, flex account.
You have hailstorm, who's going to take care of? Getting somebody to take care of.
Which are much fun.
Under 11.
Under 11?
Supervising hands for not keep the city on facilities.
Just a minute, I thought I read that somewhere else, Ray, just a minute.
You know, there again, you know, we have this message that comes in here on our gas. We have a gas something.
Leaker problem, yeah.
Gas emergency. Well, I don't think the city clerk needs to be the one involved in that. I mean, they might take the message, but...
That's all the Rick and Mark.
Rick and Mark are the ones that's more authorized to do that stuff. Even in an emergency situation, then why do we have to have the city clerk involved?
No.
And they're not really day-to-day people out there either.
They just pass that off to Rick and Mark.
I guess, again, it just depends upon who you end up hiring.
Yeah.
Maybe that person wants to be involved.
Yeah, the guy wants to be involved. Maybe he'll get his water permit. Maybe he or she will do this or that. You don't know. I don't know if the city clerks will bust that balls to the wall job 40 hours a week anyway.
Thirteen, do we actually have any licenses from this or why for
village?
Number 17. I didn't think about that one, yeah.
Well, Mark does a lot of it anyway.
Yeah, I know.
Actually, we both did a lot of it.
You do all the paperwork and of it.
All the paperwork to get it ready.
think the city clerk is more responsible, not for the supervision of the performance of the contract, but more the, you know, the financial accounting of the contract. You know, that they would go out there and supervise contractors and...
No. How would be, what would be a better wording on that, John? Rather than supervising their performance.
I'm trying to come up with something that would be, but, you know, basically the accounting of the contracts, you know, financial.
Yeah, and then you take the financial, if we want to put that word in there.
Supervises the performance. Supervises the financing. Supervises the financing of all contracts.
The administration of all contracts.
Yeah, something like that.
Administration. Just take performance out, right? Supervises the administration.
What's it? Well, then they got to actually write the contract or go through the contract or whatever.
They got to do all the ordering.
No, they'll do the ordering. Mark's done all the ordering for that Twilight project they need, right?
No, the engineer does.
Engineer.
Puts the line up and then she just tells him, go ahead, yeah. That's about it.
Engineer set the wall.
Well, we know you don't do that.
I leave it alone.
Who cares?
You know what? What's going to work?
Regardless of what the project says, it's going to know where...
She's going to be knowledgeable of it, or he or she will be knowledgeable of it and have to keep track of it.
That's true.
To that, you say supervisor.
So that it doesn't matter.
No more contracts.
Yeah, the condition would sound better with it.
And I guess performance completion is part of performance, too. Mm-hmm.
Really?
The one thing I just didn't have one person reporting instead of having maybe your administrators or your clerk reporting the financial side of it, and then somebody else got to come in and tell you, well, this is where we're at on the project.
She might as well be, or he or she may as well.
That is what we've asked these guys to do now, is to come to meetings and give us this update.
But I think if they'd have a better working relationship with these guys, they wouldn't have to be here.
How about 18? Do you want this person to be our city representative?
That should be optional if she wants to, or he.
They're going to be, they'll be working with Northwest League of Cities. They'll be working with Sac County League of Cities.
I don't know if a guy can hold somebody to that. I think that's an optional thing. They're going to have to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That one they'll have to do.
And 26.
Mm-hmm.
Be allowed to finance about.
That's just going to be good.
So,
Paperwork.
27. Identify and addresses training needs in staff. Monitors work of subordinates. takes action to correct deficient performance of subordinates?
I don't like any of that.
Hmm?
I don't like any of that.
I don't either.
I mean, training needs of the staff should be, I mean, Rick and Mark have to know the training needs, right?
Yeah.
But should we?
I left the rest of it.
Who's going to run the human relations?
Well, I left that in there. Okay. Well, I left that in there. Prepares and maintains a comprehensive human relations program, identifies and addresses training needs and staff. I mean, sometimes there's some training stuff that needs to be done. What did you do here lately?
Yes.
And wasn't there a CPR class you took in here?
No, we got to do one coming up.
Yeah. 25, it would be the same thing. We just add that to 25. Because they're saying, obtain all pertinent information for each employee's personal file. What part of training is that?
Yeah, you can combine 25 and 27, but what we took out of 27, though.
Right.
There's going to be a process and employees have a problem.
You got to have somebody that they go to. She's basically the HR person, so. Or he. Keep saying she. That. So, it will be the HR person, so.
And this person will be the HR person.
Yeah.
Ability to perform advanced statistical and mathematical techniques. What the hell does that mean?
I have no idea.
Shuffle numbers.
We'll see.
lined up that way.
We don't have to, so the building will do it.
Lined up that way anymore. Required special qualifications, you want to take number two out?
Well, just because it's not resided in the city, huh?
Yeah.
$31.2 that would be about $15 an hour.
That's if you're at 40. I don't know.
And then of course you got the how much will be on the order paper, $400 a month.
Oh, for the health.
For the health fund.
That's under 4,800 then. So you're up to 36,000 there. That's equal probably.
Yeah, most people don't look at, you know, most people don't see your benefit as,
yeah.
No, I don't.
Is worth this much money.
Yeah, because I mean, I agree with you, you have to have security. Yeah.
Usually, first salary plus benefits this.
You can probably take 3 out of those 4 out then. So it's my feelings on the whole thing.
3 out of 4 for what?
Applicants that you want to interview.
Because of the money?
Yeah, Shelly can't laugh.
No, you can put 30 to 35.
I'm not so sure. You can't have them. You can call them the city clerk, but they're still going to run the city. I don't know why we can't expect them to do more than just the city clerk.
True. But
I think if she's got some another he or she area, has another person in here helping out. Mm-hmm. You.
Which makes a big difference.
Takes a lot of load off this person. He shouldn't be able to have administrative duties to do too also. Else you don't need two people in this office. If all you're going to do is accounting, let's get out. Let's just forget it. I think you're wasting somebody's time.
Yeah, but the first thing you need to do is just get the accounting.
That's true. But I don't think there's enough real work in this community for two people. Just in accounting. You're going to have some administrative duties, or you know, you're wasting somebody's time. Or there's going to be time wasted, put it that way. You know, we had one person here around the whole damn thing, what you was doing before. Until we decide we need an administrator, well, let's get someone that's willing to do both.
Who was doing that? Sharon?
Yeah.
You're telling me Sharon was running the whole city crew?
Well, pretty much. Well, Burkhofer took care of the outside. That's true.
Yeah, and then we had Lynn Billhauer.
Right, after that.
Yeah.
And Penny.
Sharon was the clerk.
Penny basically had the time to take care of it all.
Yeah.
He was, you know, more or less.
But you got like grants that can be rolled and all that kind of stuff that can be done too, right?
Yeah, you can do, you're going to have at least a person and a half to do the position.
I believe it. I believe a person. Yeah.
If you want grants, if you want other things done, then you gotta have a full time person.
And they can pay for themselves.
Yeah,
by doing that.
I think you could work into that position. But I agree with you. Now that you take a hard look at it, you know, $35 just ain't a lot of money.
What did you pay me?
$35.
That's with overtime.
I know this is going to come out.
Well, I'm just saying.
I know. That's right. That's.
And the reason why I get paid that much is because it's a small town.
But I was figuring on the financial and the accounting capabilities and stuff like that. Depending on who you pick, I mean, I don't know if you're going to get anybody.
Like I said, you can say, throw 3 out of those 4 away. I'll guarantee it at 35. You can bring them in, want to stay 35, I said, oh, thanks for your time.
Yeah, well, we want to work for that dollar amount of
money. Yeah.
So we threw that
you
one
get what you paid for.
We threw that one out early. I didn't notice one that was asking for that one.
Well, you know,
but I did notice quite a few of that.
The other side of it is the approach we have taken before is let's pay somebody $45,000 to be a city administrator. That didn't work.
Wow. The last one was let's give it a raise to be an administrator.
So that would be hired at 45 and.
Yeah. The one before that, yeah.
Yeah, Steve came in here and got his degree and left.
Yeah.
his title. So we know what we're up against there too, you know, it's a stepping stone for people who want to leave.
I thought we were going to pay money at 32 or 3 or something like that.
That's what she started out with.
Starting out, that's what I was thinking.
What is this?
As a clerk. I think it started at 35.
I do too.
Well, 35.
So we start her at 35 and Steve at 45 is what I think. Yes.
Well, I'm sure it's been 32.
Let's ask Michelle a question then. How much more is a job entitled in what you're doing than what you're doing?
How much more?
You know, we look for, you're not doing general ledger work.
No, I'm not doing general ledger work.
So,
I'm not that I can't learn it, not that I haven't had experience with it, but no, I'm not doing it. That position also has collection duties. I'll call people and say, hey, you know, it goes late. But as far as coming right down saying, guess what, today is, it's your day. That position was in the other office. Grants and the accounting for those grants. She did that.
All the human resource stuff and the training, correct? You're not going
to
pay that?
Yeah, to a certain extent, yeah.
You're not going
to
pay that, are you?
Yeah, well, I am now.
Needless to say, whoever you hire is going to have to be trained the way you guys want to be done. So anybody you do, even if you get somebody with a lot of experience, you still want them to do it this your way.
Well, I'm going to have to uphold the city ordinances and things like that to make sure I follow them.
Right. City clerk has some responsibilities. Mm-hmm. Code of Iowa, I guess.
Code of Iowa, some responsibilities.
Plus,
financial is the biggest part of the clerk's position. It's that my understanding from what I've read in the book.
That and some good customer relations.
I don't have to do it. You can shut the door. It can fit behind the door. If necessary, I mean, if we're in our position, I greet people every day.
That's what I mean, though, I think.
I answer the phones, I greet the people. Predominantly, that's in my office, right? And has been.
But if there's a question on something...
If there's a question on...
Then it moves past you.
Yeah. If I can't make... If I don't have the authority to make the decision, then it moves.
But you haven't had to tell anybody that they are not paying their bill and you're going to be shutting electricity off or anything?
I send out notices. I haven't had to do that yet. It's where I'm more Antonio.
Where somebody's going to go to the library again.
And now I've dealt with that.
I didn't tell them to do that.
Well, what we're looking at some kind of split management position between somebody's going to, you know, administrative and finance and that kind of stuff.
You do the payroll and up.
See, anybody you hire.
And invoices.
I prepare the bills for Francis.
Right.
The administrator went over them to verify that the accounts that I put them into were correct. Just another set of eyes, and then Francis went over there. The minutes obviously were done by the clerk. Other than that, I do all the billing. The guys bring the, if somebody's moving in, moving out, I take all of that information. Call in, sewers, wet water, whatever they call me. I distribute those.
Anybody you hire, unless they have past experience as a city clerk, is going to have school.
A lot learning.
They're going to need some education.
Care which one of them you do.
Yeah, they're going to need education.
They're going to walk in and be able to do
it. Who's going to pay for it? Where the city's going to pay for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to be a walk in and do it.
That's why.
Three years.
Three. You gain experience while you're taking your classes, but it takes 3 years to complete it.
Really?
You thought about the position.
How much schooling? I mean, do they go every week or?
It was what Marlene was doing during the week, during the summer, and then there's a spring and a fall where you can get also extra CEUs.
It's kind of like water treatment.
Yeah, okay.
And what did that take you that time? A year, 2 months?
Well, I went to
Omaha
for 2 weeks so I could knock off 6 months off it so I could go get licensed there. If you took that course, then they'd take 6 months off. Otherwise, you had to have 2 years experience for grade one.
Yeah, for grade one, yeah.
Yeah, I knew it was quite
three
a lot.
For grade two. Yeah. So I'm eligible to take grade two.
So, Rick, I have a question for you. You know, there's basically three of you, four of you, I guess, that work around the city and do all this work for the city. Are one of you the supervisor, or are you all basically doing your own thing?
I kind of do a lot of it.
So, it's pretty much like it's always been in the past. We had Bert Koffer, and we had Bill Howard, and presently you're kind of taking charge.
Kind of, yeah. Haven't been appointed to, but they asked me.
Yeah, so should we be looking more at the job description for a city supervisor?
It's complicated yet, aren't they?
No, I'm just saying, I think we seem to have this duality going on where we're looking for somebody to do the books and records and the financial part of it, including grants and all that kind of stuff, which they don't want to get their hands dirty, and then we have people outside that really keep the city functioning. And so maybe we should have duality in our supervision. Management, or whatever you call it. What's our management chart look like?
Right now, yeah.
I mean, I think we're the top of the management chart. But
actually, we do there right now. Just technically, we don't.
But you distribute the workload, basically, between you and Gerald and Austin, correct?
And Mark, a little bit, but
yeah, if there's no electrical projects for Mark, then you tell him, you need to do this and this and this, and we need to get this done.
Yeah, I don't think that's the job of this person that we're going to hire, that we're going to tell them that, you know, you got to go out and fix this and fix that and make sure it's all running outside.
Well, they will, or she will. If she gets the call, if something's wrong, she's going to have to, or he.
I know, but if I had a something wrong with my water line in my house, I wouldn't have Rexona.
You typically get a call down to City Hall.
Sure.
City Hall. Right. She relates her
heat. And they don't get all of them get back.
Whatever.
I mean, that's
doesn't make it a supervisor.
Yeah, but you do that now, don't you, Michelle?
And I think that 2 years ago we asked these guys to do that.
What is that?
We said one of you has to step up and be in charge here because we don't know what's going on the street. I made that comment 2 years ago that one of you would come to the top.
Sounds like brick ass.
Well, I know, and that's when we do our job review, that's what I think we need to take into consideration.
You think we should keep on advertising for more?
Well, I think one of these people could handle what we're talking about here as far as the office.
Like on Tony Camp, when you camped down and you threw her out, but you kept Chris Rodman and you took Tony out because she had no experience.
Just threw two of them out. Was Benke and Tony for no experience? Yeah, I have no idea why that's right.
I think that don't make no sense.
Well, he had some accounting capabilities, and he was at UAP, he was working with a lot of the rebate programs from the manufacturers, rebate programs with retailers. So yeah, he does have a little bit of accounting there. How in depth, you'd have to ask him, because I really don't know. I do know what part of what his job responsibilities were at UAP. So he was working the numbers.
You jump on the trench, you probably could do that.
Well, I got no problem with Chris. I'm not downplaying, I just didn't understand what
no, you're saying. No, I know what you're
doing. Tony out when she's going to school to work on it, which I understand she don't have no experience. But wouldn't that be better off to try to teach somebody your guys' way? You know, John? As to have buck heads with somebody that's going to do it their way? Well, I've known this way for 20 years.
Well, I guess that would be fine if they had some training, some on-the-job training. If you know, if she's coming out of school and if Weston is coming out of school,
mm-hmm.
who's supposed to train them the way we want them to do it? If Michelle's been trained, then we'll just make her city clerk.
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm wondering about. You could just have a shared responsibility with Michelle and her. For what? Or something to that effect, you know what I'm saying?
Well, I certainly would like to hire somebody that's not going to put our general ledger together and give us reports and tell us how the city's functioning.
Yeah.
That's what I...
Yeah, I want to hire somebody that comes in here and train them our way. Who's going to train them? Are you going to train them? Are you going to train them?
No.
I don't want to train them. I just want to yell at them when they don't give me what I want.
There you go. That's training.
That's training.
That's how we get trained.
Okay. Well, did you want to decide on a base salary? Did you want to start at?
Leave it broad.
Well, I don't know. 30 to 40 sounds good. I don't think 30 is probably enough.
No, I don't either. But you know, it depends on what you're looking at. What's your, if you know, if we're going to train somebody or send him off to him or her or whatever off to school for half a year or something like that, or maybe reevaluate after putting a period of time in there.
How soon does council want to interview these people?
Do you want to be enough first? Do you want me or however it is done to explain to them that this comes out of the range of the expectations?
Probably.
Are you interested in interviewing?
To locate them, ask them if they're interested in that range. You don't have to worry about calling them in.
Oh, a waste of time for an interview.
Yeah.
Because if you're done with interviewing and you say 30 to 40 and they look at you like, well, thanks for your time, but you just wasted my time. So that's a good point. That's a very good point.
And when you're saying the 30 to 40, though, give them the benefits too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, we can go
and kind of tell them what they're going to be getting into.
Yeah.
Hey, you're going to revise this?
I mean, I'll give them this. Can you have Travis come over tomorrow?
Yep. And, Why don't you try and get a hold of these four this week, and then we'll put you on the agenda to report on what these four, if they like the interview or not. We can discuss that the 24th at our council meeting. The 24th. If they're all four interested, then we can decide the council meeting when we want to sit down and have an interview. That sound good? Okay. Work session is over. Thank you all for coming.
Just for clarity, what are the names of the four candidates?
Chris Rodman.
No, I don't know.
Thomas Meyer, Patricia Smith,
check the pin.
Thank you.
Well, it worked.